Welcome back to the IBSP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Canelo Alvarez and Jermall Charlo next. Look, let's break it down honestly and objectively as possible. And according to Mike Coppinger with ESPN, he states, and I quote, "It's more likely that Canelo Alvarez fights Jermall Charlo in May than Alongu Makabu." He also states that Canelo Alvarez and his team are in negotiations with Jermall Charlo and his team to get that fight done for May. So the negotiations are currently ongoing. That's a fight that they're currently pursuing. And, you know, this makes a lot of sense when you look at the situation overall. You've seen Jermall Charlo recently come out on his social media stating that he's the biggest super middleweight in the world. Obviously, Jermall Charlo would be moving up to 168 pounds, so it makes sense what he's saying on his social media now. In addition to that, you've also seen Eddie Reynoso, before Canelo Alvarez even fought Caleb Plant, stating that, hey, after we fight Caleb Plant, I would like to fight Jermall Charlo, Errol Spence, and David Benavidez next. And you see it's all lining up. That is the hit list Canelo Alvarez has had, and that looks to be going down that path. Not only that, you know, you've seen Canelo Alvarez blindsided by the fact that Eddie Reynoso had even started potential negotiations with Alongu Makabu. Canelo Alvarez stated, "I didn't even know about that," how he was blindsided, and he found out on social media like everyone else. But not only that, you know, Canelo Alvarez, you know, rejected an opportunity to go attend the WBC cruiserweight title fight with Alongu Makabu that Don King offered him. He was not interested in it. It appears that Jermall Charlo is the way they're going. Now, the funny thing about all this is, all the people that say Canelo Alvarez don't fight black fighters, all the people that say Canelo Alvarez is ducking black fighters, and all the people that are saying that Canelo Alvarez is running from Jermall Charlo, they will be silenced if this fight gets announced. They will have nothing to say, and they'll have their thumb up their ass. They will have nothing to say. Now, the interesting thing is there are going to be a different group of haters, and they're going to say, oh, Jermall Charlo shouldn't be fighting at 168. Jermall Charlo this, Jermall Charlo that. It will be a laundry list of excuses as to why Jermall Charlo should not be fighting Canelo Alvarez next. They will try to discredit Canelo Alvarez before the fight even takes place. Mark my words. Because men lie, women lie, but the facts don't lie.